The year is 1590 and the population of Ireland is 1 million. Since prehistoric times up until now, the diet of the Irish hadn't strayed from cereals, pork and milk. Writer John Stevens wrote, "The people of this time generally were the greatest lovers of milk he ever saw. They drank thick milk, thin milk, yellow milk you had to chew." Flash forward 250 years to 1840. The population of Ireland is 8.2 million, making the country the most densely populated in Europe. Armadas and conquests had brought new worlds together, and one vegetable from South America hitting the shores of Ireland in the 1600s helped unite and grow the Irish classes. Prawtie, the potato. Plentiful, cheap and nutritious, the potato was a sustainability powerhouse. It combated famine, could be grown underground away from war and cold almost year-round. Colcannon, mashed potato with kale, became popular around Ireland. And Aran Bochtie, or Boxtie, a potato pancake, found its place in the heart of North Midlanders. However, while it broadened the cuisines of the rich, it narrowed the cuisines of the poor, who became over-reliant on the tuber. And in 1845, a disease, Phytophthora infestans, or blight, deleted three-quarters of all crops, leading to the devastation of An Gorta Mór, the Great Famine. By 1851, over a million people died and a million more emigrated to avoid starvation. This evacuation continued for the next 100 years. A lot has changed since that time. Cheap foods are more available from around the world and the wealth of the lower classes has grown. Potato growing practices have become more concerted and efficient, and even NASA has considered making engineered virus-free potatoes the staple food for long-haul space flights, with the growing plant providing oxygen and capturing CO2. Plants are a big part of our past and are very much our future. If you don't buy and eat them, try them. Better yet, grow your own.